What scares you most? Many people worry about dying. What scares me even more is being in terrible pain. To me, that would be worse than death. But at least I know that I live in modern America. There are medications that will ease my pain. These are some of the best. It's comforting to know that they exist. Trouble is, if I'm in terrible pain, there's no guarantee that I'll be able to get them or enough of them to kill my pain. Why? Because doctors are scared. If they prescribe those, the police and prosecutors may wreck their life.
Dr. James Graves was the first doctor to be convicted of manslaughter and sent to jail for prescribing painkillers. That's him on the right, 8 years ago, hugging his family after a Florida jury sentenced him to 63 years in jail. Other doctors were sentenced later.
A Virginia doctor gets 25 years in prison for trafficking in painkiller. A South Carolina physician is sentenced to 30 years for selling pain drugs to addicts.
Selling to addicts, trafficking. That's what the authorities call it. And in some cases, doctors have prescribed drugs for people who just wanted to get high. America's war on drugs has zero tolerance for that.
40 states now require a prescription drug monitoring program at pharmacies to keep track of prescription abuse.
But what is abuse? Sean Clark Redman is in constant pain because he has Lou Gehrig's disease. And his caretaker and partner says Sean's problem isn't overdosing.
This is underdosing.
Sean's in pain because doctors will not give him more painkillers.
They're afraid if they write that prescription, oh my God, they're going to get locked in jail. They're going to get put away.
The harder they clamp down, the harder it is for me to live with this disease.
When he doesn't have the medication, it's hell.
One study found more than half the people with severe chronic pain do not get adequate pain relief. You'd think nursing homes would at least make sure the elderly don't suffer, but no. The Journal of the American Medical Association says 41% of nursing home residents endure severe chronic pain. Why? Because the best painkillers are opioids.
OxyContin.
Demerol. Vicodin.
And the DEA is upset about them.
I was arrested when a SWAT team of about 20 law enforcement officials descended on my clinic at 9 in the morning.
Dr. Frank Fisher treats poor people in Northern California.
Poor people are already suspected of being drug addicts and criminals, and so are the doctors that treat them with controlled substances.
Dr. Fisher was charged with drug trafficking, and because some of his patients died with pain meds in their system, he was also charged with murder.
They were trying to give me 256 to life.
Eventually, the charges were dropped, but the doctor spent 5 months in this jail and spent all his savings on legal fees.
At this point, I'm 56 years old, and I'm starting over, and I have a net worth of zero.
So you can see why doctors are nervous. Ronald Libby is the author of The Criminalization of Medicine. He joins us now from Florida. Siobhan Reynolds runs a group called the Pain Relief Network, and she started that because her husband had a disease that left him in terrible pain, and when they finally found the doctor who'd prescribe enough pain medication, that doctor was arrested.
Yes.
What happened?
Well, it took us years and years and years to find this doctor. My husband was incapacitated with pain, stuck in bed, and the doctors just wouldn't give him enough pain medication in the different kinds of doses, and I later found out why. It's because the DEA considers giving different kinds of meds to one person. They call that a cocktail, and that sort of, that you know, raises the red flags, and then the DEA can come in and arrest the doctor, which is what happened to my husband's doctor.
And you, even in looking for doctors, went to doctor appointments wearing a fur coat? Why?
Yeah, well, because I found out after talking to some doctors that what they were worried about was that we might sell the medication. And it had never occurred to me that I had to sort of put on a show so that they might,
to
you
look
know,
rich.
Right, so that they didn't have to worry that I would sell them.
And your husband passed away in great pain?
He did. And what really was so horrifying about it is that the doctor who told us to never let him get into pain actually cut him off from his medications because he was concerned that he would, if he were cut off, that he would get a cerebral hemorrhage, which is, in fact, what happened 2 weeks later.
Ronald Libby, the criminalization of medicine?
The government, and primarily the DEA, has made doctors scapegoats for the failure of the war on drugs.
There's one thing that astounded me. I read it on the website of the Association of the American Physicians and Surgeons. This is their advice to doctors. If you're thinking about getting into pain management using opioids as appropriate, don't. Forget what you learned in med school. Drug agents now set medical standards. There could be years of harassments and legal fees.
The DEA tracks very carefully all opioid prescriptions. And they do this through druggists, pharmacies. They do it through the drug companies that manufacture the product. And they're constantly surveilling these scripts.
Siobhan, your son, who's with us now, has the same disease your husband had.
Yeah, he does. He has Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, which can cause a great deal of pain and will likely. And it also, again, it gives him insufficient strength in his arteries and in his veins. So he has to keep his pain under control in order to survive.
So, Ronan, are you worried about this?
I'm more than worried. I'm terrified. I know it's imminent. I couldn't not be in agony in my later years if things keep up the way they are.
And your fear is that the DEA will continue to crack down on these things and you just won't get the pain relief?
They've set a pattern of doing so.
The DEA declined our request for an interview, but sent us a statement saying the DEA's mission is to protect the public health and safety. Doctors who issue controlled substance prescriptions for a legitimate medical purpose and the course of professional practice have nothing to fear. On average, the DEA arrests only 85 doctors annually. Their statement's much longer. If you want to read it, you can go to johnstossel.com. But what's your reaction to that?
They've been saying that for years, and it's not true. What they do is they take doctors who were being physicians, they bring them into federal court, they make them look guilty in the media ahead of time, and because they put out that statement, people assume, well, they must have done something wrong because the DEA says they're only arresting bad guys.
Well, maybe they are. I mean, some of these doctors are selling to people who are just using them for recreational use.
Undoubtedly, that's true. It's got to be true. Unfortunately, I've been at over 20 trials across the United States, and I haven't seen it one time. They don't hold to the actual standard. They end up defining what the practice of medicine is by putting up their own expert who basically says whatever it is that the government wants to say. So they sort of implant that idea in the jury's mind that the guy's a criminal because he didn't do it the way the government wanted.
Usually the DEA goes after doctors, but sometimes they go after the patient. Here's one sick man who was sent to prison.
The Florida Clemency Board voted unanimously to release Pei from his 25-year sentence for drug trafficking today.
On this day, Richard Pei was finally released from jail. He served 3 years, but then the governor pardoned him.
It's like Dorothy going home.
Pei went to jail because he was caught with 700 Percocet tablets.
All along, police have conceded Pei never sold drugs. He had, though, acquired large amounts of prescription narcotics to mute massive pain from a broken back and multiple sclerosis. But because the quantity this man had possessed was illegal, and because he was getting an out-of-state doctor to prescribe them, the state moved to prosecute him.
Ron, some people have committed suicide because they were in such pain and they just couldn't get the medications?
Yes, that's not uncommon. And the few physicians who are willing to write script and provide adequate treatment for the pain are overwhelmed by patients coming from all over the country. And, of course, that's a red flag for the DEA.
Siobhan, you make the point that these new forfeiture rules encourage the drug agents to grab doctors. Why?
The forfeiture laws make it so that any number of ways, any number of agencies, police agencies, from the local all the way up to the feds, end up being able to seize all of the doctor's assets. So that if you are a doctor who's popular and you make a good living, you can forget about it. They're going to come and take everything away. And they'll take the money before you're actually in trial so that you can't even hire an attorney. That's what they do.